Capricorn, hi, how are you doing? Hope you're doing fine. Let's do your reading for the month of June 2020 for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter signs. I'm going to look at the cards and see what we have for you in the month of June. Even Sagittarius has got this card. Major Arcana to start the reading, so definitely very important message you have for the month of June, Capricorn. And you got Chariot, the Chariot. And just to mention that Capricorn, the zodiac sign Capricorn, starts with the letter C. And you got Chariot, which is Major Arcana, and Chariot also starts with the letter C. So, and also you can see this crescent moon over here in the right in the forehead. Okay, that's the third eye chakra, and also it is in the letter C. You can see this crescent moon will also form a shape which is similar to the letter C. Okay, so the letter C is definitely significant for you in the month of June. Okay, watch out for that. It has to do with some crescent moon. During crescent moon, during its waning, okay, definitely in the waning moon time, you'll be experiencing few shift of energies, especially Chariot. Okay, so Chariot is movement, so definitely there'll be shift of energies in the waning time of the moon. Check your location and see what phase the moon is, and take care of yourself, okay, during that time. Whoa. So I'm gonna take one card, which is the Wheel of Fortune. Definitely few cards have dropped, which is also Major Arcana. Wheel of Fortune is Major Arcana. Two Major Arcanas in the reading. First two cards, as I said, it's a very major message you have in the month of June. Watch out for that. And even Wheel of Fortune has this crescent moon, as I said, the C, but this is in the reverse, okay? And that's the reason many cards are falling down. You can see this, there is sun over here and there's crescent moon over here. This is up, sun is up, whereas the crescent moon is down. And this is the exact opposite. Crescent moon is up and the sun is down, and also you can see the crescent moon is in the mirror, it's reflecting, so it is opposite, as above so below. In this case also, sun is up, sun is down, crescent moon is facing to the right, whereas this moon is facing to the left. So as above so below, definitely there is some spiritual process which is going on, which is reflecting to you, as above so below. So something from the higher dimensions is reflecting your personality and your energies, okay? And Wheel of Fortune is wheel turning on towards your favor. So psychically I can say that few cards have dropped while this card has come out, okay? So when this Wheel of Fortune is presented to you, some opportunities when it's presented to you, you'll be moving fast with the Chariot card, with the Chariot energy. So while moving, you will actually not able to notice or grasp the Wheel of Fortune, and that's the meaning of cards falling down along with it, okay? So you might actually, when Wheel of Fortune comes, you might actually flip over and fall down with this Chariot, okay? Chariot is movement, you riding the horse like the chariot and moving fast. Because this horse is moving fast, you can see the hair is you can see it is in movement, and few cards have dropped down when this card came out. So while you're in this movement, and when Wheel of Fortune is presented to you, because there is as above so below, up and down, okay, you might actually flip over So you might not be in the track. Okay, you might go out of track when Wheel of Fortune energy comes in. Wheel of Fortune is good, okay, but you might actually either get excited, or since it is unexpected, you might actually flip over, okay, or do something wrong, or you might actually end up injuring yourself in some or the other way. Okay, so watch out for that. These two are major arcanas. I feel like you want to stay up at night and work hard for your growth, spiritual growth as well. You might stay awake at night, and because as above so below, and this chariot is having a crescent moon. I just saw four of wands in the bottom of the deck, which is home. So definitely it relates. You in your home, you are actually staying awake, okay, at night for your spiritual growth. That is also seen here. But actually, that card wanted to come out. Wow, I guess this is the only zodiac sign who has got three major arcanas, like a hat trick, you know, at a row. So death is also major arcana. I guess for you Capricorn, definitely June is a very significant month for you. Maybe for Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter signs, if you have Capricorn placement in Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter signs, I feel like you might be having birthday. Okay, death card is also birthday. It represents birthday. We have to remember that I believe as per astrological point of view and even spiritual point of view, they say your birthday is not your actual birthday. Your birthday is when Sun and Moon have the same distance when you're born. So that's the reason when your birthday comes, you don't feel that emotions, you just feel like a normal day. So that's not your actual birthday, okay? When your actual birthday is like when Sun and Moon are in the same distance, okay? That's what many people say as in astrological point of view. So death card is also birthday, or you might run into as I said, Sun and Moon might be same distance in the month of June for you, okay? That's your soul's thing. Even when I was a kid, I was just wondering, okay, birthday means it should be a special one. Why I'm not feeling like a special day? Six of Wands, yeah. Six of Wands. Wow. Actually, death card next to Six of Wands, I actually saw a reading just before I start this. I saw two readings for myself, for me. And one of the reading, I have got Death and Six of Wands. So, Death and Six of Wands is, you know, Death card next to Six of Wands, or Six of Wands next to Death card, either ways. You know, sudden fame, you know. I feel like you'll wake up and you'll realize you achieved a lot of fame, okay? You have achieved victory. Death next to the Six of Wands. Six of Wands is victory. And if it comes next to Death card, it's like sudden fame, okay? You wake up, overnight success it is. I believe you got chariot, so you're working on your finances. As I said, your growth and your finances. Growth, spiritual growth is the crescent moon, and here pentacle, the coin, is your finances. You're working and moving towards the growth of your finances and spiritual growth. So you got Wheel of Fortune, but you might flip over because you might be excited or unexpected. You might be unexpected. And you got Death card and Six of Wands, which is, you know, overnight success. This is your wish, you wished for it, okay. Yeah, another major arcana. Four out of five major arcanas. It would be crazy if all the cards were major arcanas. I don't know if that will happen. It might happen actually. High Priestess is secrets. You have a lot of secrets, you also might know a lot of secrets, okay? As a human being, you know how a person is, you know. You might actually be a doctor, or you might actually be a psychologist, okay? High priestess. High priestess is someone who is diplomatic, you know, who has finished a lot of education, who is very, very much educated. High priestess, a diplomatic. You might be a lawyer also. Someone who has a lot of high, who completed a very high education. Not everyone does. Maybe PhD and something which is, which involves a lot of mind, okay, a lot of secrets which no one knows. You might be an astrologer also, okay. Actually, Six of Wands next to High Priestess also means your knowledge is improving, okay. As you grow and as you flourish, your secrets also, you're getting to know a lot of secrets, okay, about the universe. You'll be having that aha moment, like, okay, now I realize what is going on, you know. As you get along with your journey, you'll have that moment. Okay, that wanted to come out and that was fast. Daughter of Swords, okay, a sword energy. Yeah, you're learning, you know, you're learning. You're not stopping. You have the victory. You achieve the victory, overnight success, but you're not stopping there. You're continuously learning. You feel like education is something which is very important and you're not stopping. Okay. Daughter of Swords is someone... Yeah, Daughter of Swords, actually it is someone who is working on medical field also. Okay. Many books have written that Daughter of Swords. If you get Daughter of Swords with few major arcanas, it means that, especially High Priestess, you might be a doctor, okay, or working in medical field. Daughter of Swords also means that in your childhood, you had an ambition to become something, like to have a profession, and after you've grown up, you have achieved that successfully. That is Daughter of Swords, okay. Or if you're not at a place where you're earning right now, that means whatever you're doing right now, whatever ambitions you have, whatever goals you have to become something, and if you're working on that, then successfully you will be that, okay? You will achieve the victory. Because you got Six of Wands also, yeah. Three of Pentacles relates, okay? If you're already in a medical field, if you're already a doctor, if you're already, you know, you might be an astrologer also with the High Priestess. Pranic healers, all kinds of healers will get these kind of cards. High Priestess, Daughter of Swords, Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles is again growth, you know, something which you have dreamed about in the past, and you'll achieve victory. If you keep building this mountain, if you keep up with this mountain, and you already have the base strong, and this mountain keeps on building up, okay, as days goes on. So that's good. Swords also is very intellectual person, you know. Swords is the mind. So you're working on that and you're building the pentacles, okay, which is money. So as days goes on, you might be also earning a lot of money, okay. So you can see the finances will start to improve as you work on yourself, as you develop your knowledge even more regarding that field you're in. Wow, three, this card also wanted to come out. It was crazy. I saw this card, so I'll keep it in this order. You got Three of Cups and Daughter of Cups, okay. So this is definitely as above, so below. You can see you got Daughter of Swords and this is as above and as below, you got Daughter of Cups. As above, you got Three of Pentacles. As below, you got Three of Cups. And same relates to Chariot and Wheel of Fortune explained before. Okay. So Three of Cups and Three of Pentacles, you got three and three. So synchronicity is something which is significant. The letter C is significant. C for Capricorn, C for Chariot, C for Crescent Moon. Okay. Three and three, three might be significant. You might actually meet new friends. Okay. You might actually meet. Yeah. Three of Pentacles next to the Three of Cups, you will be meeting a foreigner, you know. You might be meeting foreigners, foreign friends, international, okay. It is like close contact, even though they are distant from you, you will actually have a bond which is very close. You can see the three pentacles are very close and connected. Even here, the three cups are close to each other and the three birds are close to each other, okay. So that's definitely there. Three and three, double the energy, okay. Now Daughter of Cups, you got Daughter of Swords also, again double the energy. It amplifies the previous element, which is Daughter of Swords. So you're actually keeping the emotions, and as you're learning, even sword is intellectual. As you're learning things, you're actually keeping your emotions, which is cups. You're providing the cups to the swords, because if you get daughter again, which is the same, you know, daughter and daughter, court cards. Since it is court cards, these cups will give the energy for the swords. So that means as you're learning, you're actually providing the emotions to it. You're adding the emotions so you can learn more. Okay, that is the meaning. So your friends also, your foreigners, international people whom you'll be meeting very closely, even though they are far, they'll actually bring you this cup energy from you. This is not their cup. Daughter of Cups is from you, but they are helping you to get it. They are actually teaching you how to be more emotional. They might talk things which is more emotional, and that will actually bring your emotions out, because you didn't get cups energy till now. You were in the swords, major arcanas, which is all your physical self. Major arcana is physical, minor is inside. Okay, again, it has divisions. Okay, it has divisions, and it'll be based on divisional things. Even in chart also, astrological chart, you have D1, D2 till D24 or something, D23, you have divisional charts. Same in tarot also, it's the same thing. They are divisions. And this is the first cup element you got, which is Three of Cups, because the cup energy is starting from with your friends, okay. So they are actually bringing you this cup energy. They're actually making your emotions come out, okay. They might actually talk about, okay, let me know what is your favorite thing, you know, since your childhood, what do you want to become, and they might share their things, their emotions, their childhood memories. You might share your childhood memories with them, so that kind of connection. And due to this, you'll actually reflect your emotions out, okay. And you got exactly below Six of Wands, Daughter of Cups, you got exactly below Six of Wands. It also means that as you're sharing these emotions out, people see you as, definitely you have achieved a lot, you know. You came out of this darkness and flying. People see you that way, as you're actually reflecting your rainbow shadow over here. People see you as someone who is very different and special, okay. The 10th card. Wow. Well, one card has dropped. I don't know which one. I'll take four of definitely have seen few cards. There were 5 of pentacles and 8 of, yep, 7 of pentacles. So pentacles, I believe, here's the thing I'm getting. Actually some kind of emotions. It might be yours or someone else, or it might be you or someone else is actually sharing emotions which are not true. Okay, maybe they want to get attention or something like that is what I'm seeing, because 4 of cups next to the daughter of cups. Someone is faking the emotions, okay? No, because they want to have this attention from others. Daughter of cups next to the 4 of cups, okay? Actually, you got 3 in a row. This also amplifies the energy, which I said, because this is 3 and 4, okay? So definitely someone is actually faking emotions. You express your emotions which you have experienced in childhood, those are true. But there are some other emotions which are not true. It can be you or someone else in this case, okay, is what I'm seeing. And that's one thing, and that is actually blocking the pentacle energy, because as I said, few cards have dropped down, which are 5 of pentacles and 7 of pentacles. 7 of pentacles is the growth, 5 of pentacles is sadness and betrayal and feeling sad and not having others to understand you. So the pentacles is actually decreasing because it has fallen down. 7 of pentacles is growth. When it is falling down, that means it is decreasing. Okay, it is the exact opposite. I don't do reversals, but when cards fall down, basically it means when cards fall down and if I don't take it, that means either the energy should be in reverse, which is backward, like Rahu also, you know, Rahu rotates, Rahu moves the planet. Rahu is a shadow planet which moves in the opposite direction. So, and you can see Rahu is it's a shadow planet, and it kind of relates to cards falling down and not able to take it. Okay, it is very shadow. It is an illusion. Rahu is an illusion, something which is smoke, not able to see, even though you want to see. Cards falling down and not able to take, those are kind of like a smoke. Okay, so that's the thing I want to share. So watch out. If it is not you, that means someone around you is actually having this they want attention. Okay, so they want attention, so they'll actually fake emotions. They don't have that personality, but since they got a chance, they're actually doing that. Okay, bottom of the deck, Son of Wands is a Prince Charm. People see you standing out, who have achieved a lot. Definitely, if you get this in the bottom of the deck, you feel great, you know. You achieved a lot. This can be fame also. Son of Wands. All people seeing you. As I said, sudden fame, you know. Death card next to the 6 of Wands. You might actually be discovered suddenly. Out of the blue. People be like, okay, who is this guy? And you'll be discovered that way. And bottom of the deck, you got Son of Wands, which means, you know, for sure. Deep inside also, you feel this happiness. Maybe it was your dream to be that way. You know, all positive energies, guys, except for the 4 of cups over here, which is very having this sneaky kind of energy. You got exactly below the high priestess, which is also secrets. As I said, they might be lying. They might actually hold a secret. A secret can be, most of the time, a secret will be I can't say secret can be lies, but when a person is holding something, that means they did a mistake. Okay, a secret in this case is something which is caused because of them, not based on aspects, okay, or facts. It is because of them, because they shared the emotions which is not true. Due to that, there is a secret, okay. That's the thing. High priestess is a secret. So definitely someone is actually holding back some kind of, you know, secret. They are actually, they might be wanting more attention. Okay. It might be you or someone else. I don't feel like it is you, because you already have this attention. You're getting a lot of attention. Okay. With the Six of Wands, with the Three of Cups, with the Three of Pentacles, with the Daughter of Cups, with the Son of Wands, you're getting a lot of attention. I feel like it is someone else in this case. Okay. They actually, it also means that they see you reflecting this beautiful aura, and they also kind of get jealous and they want to mimic your thing, but they are not able to do it. So they're using the time for their advantage and opportunity to their advantage, and they don't want to do that. They don't have the personality, as I said, but they might actually, you might get into a few situations like that, where a person might communicate something which is not true regarding their emotions. Okay. So that's all I have for you, Capricorn. This is a beautiful reading. Many major arcanas I've got. The first five cards, out of first five cards, you got four major arcanas and three in a row, which is a hat trick. You know, 1, 2, 3. The first three cards are major arcanas. This is the only zodiac sign till now in my readings who has got this, which is so beautiful and very positive cards. You know. All positive. Death is not a negative card. It is definitely positive. It is not. Whereas Tower is definitely negative. Death is not a negative. Okay. And death next to the Six of Wands. You know, you might wake up and be like, you might realize that you are discovered suddenly. Okay. This is all I have for you, Capricorn. If you want to watch the reading again, you are free to do that. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, click on the bell icon to get notified, never miss a video. I'll definitely be making a lot of videos for you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you, Capricorn.